for the last 8 weeks at least, 2.5 months perhaps, I have been, after reading my part of the scripture that causes me to read it all the way through every year, after I get through with my prayer time, first my prayer with Frida at breakfast time, and then my personal prayer time, if it hasn't happened before, and sometimes I'm up at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4, 5. I slept late this morning. I slept till 4:50. I've been studying the kingdom. I can't describe to you what I'm feeling. If what I've found to be true is true, and I'm absolutely certain as breath is in my body and blood is flowing through my veins, I'm certain that what I'm about to tell you is true. God is big. He's up to something. He's personal. He wants you to be His so He can do His thing in you. He made you to think like Him, with Him. He wants to think as you, and He wants you to think as He thinks. So out of that, this is maybe temporary and maybe it's a rough copy, but I wrote it. I feel under the touch of God. So hear it now. This book is about a mystery. I call it the author's premise. The kingdom of God being spiritual, eternal, invisible, and the foundation of all reality cannot be routinely addressed, accessed, or assessed by the unaided human mind. And I hope that's not too heavy for you. We can't address it. We can't speak of it to it. We can't address it. We can't access it. Get its advantages for ourselves. Get in it. We can't. Nor assess it, how big it is, how important it is. We can't do any of these by the unaided human mind. We have to have help from above. This mind I've been talking about, this mind of God. The kingdom yields the riches of its unfathomable mysteries only as the Spirit of God invades, penetrates, and transcends human knowledge. Only then can any ultimate understanding and revelation be experienced. The renewed mind, touched of God, enlivened by and attentive to the Holy Spirit, can then soar into the stratosphere of revelation. Where did I get thinking like this? I wake up to that. Sometime, most every morning I awaken, aware that my mind has been thinking before I awakened. I don't know that the mind ever stops. You have subconscious, you have dreaming. I think God just goes on and does work in you while you sleep, since He doesn't have to sleep. He that keeps your soul doesn't slumber or sleep. The renewed human mind, enlivened and attentive to the Holy Spirit, can soar into the stratosphere of revelation. As the breath of God begins to breathe again on the word He breathed on long ago. The absence of revelation is fatal to the exercise and power of ultimate truth. I didn't say it's fatal to truth. It's fatal to the effects of truth. Studies of the kingdom of God without the revelatory component, that is, somebody who knows, inputting your mind, which is totally fallen and cannot think beyond your own mind. Christians may engage in such studies that are both accurate and correct, but dangerous in view of the missing component of divine revelation. In other words, You can speak the truth about the universe. 5,280, what, 5, 6 feet in a mile, and so on. Light travels at 186,282 miles a second. The Earth is this far from the Sun. We know a lot of facts. But facts about the universe or any other truth we choose to bring to the table won't save you. It will not decrease your anxiety. It will not settle your depression. It will not help you one iota. If often happens in history that when certain unheeded truths, ones left alone for years, it often happens that what we learn bereft without divine revelation becomes a system of belief, while correct, has no life. This proves tragic, and the material takes on the likeness of fads. That's the reason you have fads developing everywhere. One fad didn't work, or it was timed and needed something else. Is there one unchanging thing in the world? Yes, there is God. Everything else that is not of God, to God, through God, is changing. And that's where the term came in. Everything is a change in. Forcible change. Though the church at large, and I've lost my, I have not memorized this, so I'm handing it in for repair. But I want you to follow me through. I'm just 2 or 3 minutes away. Get used to learning with help. Revelatory learning is revelation learning. Look at me, let me give you a shocking fact. I've been to school. I went to 4 years of college. 4 years of seminary. I stretched 3 years into four. And I have yet to hear anything about what I'm talking about here. Revelatory learning. Thinking with the unaided mind was never God's intention. God wants to think in us, with us, for us. He wants to make our thinking solid. So, amid rushes to try to understand God's timetable of the future and the last things, we must never forget that there is one thing that must come to pass. Just lay aside all that you've been taught for a moment about what's going to happen in the future. What about the rapture? There's going to be a rapture. What about time of the of desolation? What about the terrible happenings of the tribulation? Before or after Jesus comes? Or how will he come? How will he come to the whole world at the same time? Every eye behold him. I don't know. I've left that up to God. This is the one thing that must happen. Here it is. The good news of the kingdom of God will be proclaimed in all the world as a testimony to the nations. And then the end will come. Wow, did you hear that? I've got a minute. Here it goes. Whatever the reader's view of last things, a subject about which there is great debate, we can confidently count on this. The gospel of Jesus Christ is going to be preached in every village, every town, every country place, out in the desert, wherever there are people, that message is going to be sounded, the good news of the kingdom of God. There have been movements in the past in which there was an intention to restore the kingdom to the church. All of them failed. Look at me. This one will not fail. You say, how do you know? I don't know how I know. I just know. Believe it. Believe it. Study it. So this is a challenge to read my book. And I'm excited about what I've found out. And I'm absolutely sure. And you know what it's done? It's made me look at my face. An excited old man. Hallelujah. Think with me. Don't let somebody else control your thinking. That's boring. You have to keep checking with them. And if they want you to do that, they're nuts. You don't need to be kin to a nut. Think. Try it. You'll like it. God bless.